they might choose to not. Believe it or not, they kind of prefer to swim when it's a little bit cooler, and especially when it's raining. If you're ever here on a rainy day, be sure to look in the pools at Toledo Elephant Passage, because they love to go in the water when it's raining. I think they kind of think, I'm already wet, might as well keep swimming. So we're going to turn the fire hose on, and we'll be heading out here soon, but if you stick around for a little bit, you might see them go swimming. A little bit about our training. As you see, they've got whistles in their mouth or around their neck. If you hear that whistle anytime you're watching a training session, that means that they did the correct behavior, the elephants. They can be done with whatever was asked of them, and they're okay to treat for doing it. So it's kind of like saying good boy. So through that kind of positive reinforcement training, we don't force our animals to do anything, and we're able to accomplish a lot of things. We can get blood draws from them voluntarily. We had a lot of elephants break their tusks on each other in the last couple weeks just from all the sparring and playing with each other. So we can actually trim their tusks back voluntarily. So that's all their choice. They can walk away whenever they want to. We don't force them to do anything, but they're getting lots and lots of good treats while they're staying still for us. So through that training, they can do a lot. I think that fire hose did encourage them to go swimming. So you'll see some elephants swimming now. Believe it or not, they're pretty good swimmers. They're more buoyant than you might think, even though these guys weigh about 8,000 pounds. And yeah, they'll actually swim. They do like a doggy paddle underwater. So Jake made it in first. There you go. He loves snacks, so he likes to anything for food. And then these guys are actually half brothers. I don't think I said that at the beginning. They're half brothers, so they like to play a lot. If you guys are wanting to know how to help Asian elephants in the wild and how you can help their numbers recover since they are an endangered species, one thing you can look out for is palm oil and see what kind of products they're using right now that uses palm oil. And try to choose products that use sustainably sourced palm oil. So Cheyenne Mountain Zoo down in Colorado Springs, if you've been there, they have all female African elephants, female Asian elephants. But they have created a free app you can download in the App Store called the Sustainable Palm Oil Shopping Guide. You just search that, it's free, you can download it, and you can actually scan the barcode of products that you have at home or that you're looking at in the grocery store, and it will tell you if that comes from a sustainable source or not. So things like shampoo, things like peanut butter, a lot of cleaning has palm oil. So just be really conscious whenever you can of what products you're using and know if it uses palm oil, and then try to choose alternatives that use sustainably sourced palm oil. And if you all did that, collectively, you can make a big difference for these guys. Thank you. Feel free to hang out and watch these guys swim as long as you want, but I'm going to get off the microphone now. Hope you have a great day at the University of these guys.
I'm going to go to the hospital.